Hi everyone, welcome to Mr. Dear Dogs. In the last session, we discussed about commonly used types in TypeScript. In this session, we'll see how to mark a property as optional parameter and how to define a function with optional parameters and how to mark that function as an optional function. In the last session, we have seen how to define an interface with list of properties like employee ID, employee name, salary, isn't, is in IT or not. Just assume if in case we are not getting this property as always and no need to process this property as always, then in that case we are going to define this property as optional parameters. Means it's up to us whether we are going to define it or not. Then we are going to mark it as optional parameters by adding a question mark to this property. Okay, if we add a question mark to the property, then we'll call it as the optional parameters. If you overrun the property, you could see employee.employeeID question mark number are undefined. In the sense, if you are not defining a value, then it's going to be by default the value will be undefined. In this employees array object, for example, if you remove this value, then we are not going to see any exception here because the employee ID will have a undefined value by default. If you remove this question mark from this property, then you could see error because it's not an optional property and it will throw an error. The property employee ID is missing in the type. That's the reason we will mark a question mark to the employee ID property if in case we are treating that as property as a undefined property or optional property. This is how we'll mark a property as a optional parameter. Just assume if you want to have a function with optional parameters, then just assume your function name is getEmployee and you are going to pass two parameters for this. One is employee ID, the type is number, employee name, the type is string, and it's going to return a void. It's not going to return anything. That's the reason the method return type will be void. And if you overrun it, then it will show the getEmployee property is missing from the type. In that case, what we'll do is we'll mark this getEmployee method as well as a optional function. Then what you need to do, first we need to add a question mark to this function and give some space, add colons, and before adding the return type, then we need to add a goes to operator. Then we are not going to get an exception here. Now we'll see how to read these properties, how to read this list of employees with the help of mapper array. There are a lot of extension methods. In this session we will see how to iterate on each object available in this employee section to check whether we could see the employee ID is undefined or not, and we'll log this information into our logger. As we discussed in the previous session, we could see all the extension methods are available in this employees array object. Employees dot, there were a lot of extension methods available in this employee subject. In this session, we will see the mapper one, which iterates on each and every value present in this object array object. If you overrun it, then this is expecting it's a callback function, which is expecting a value comma index. In the sense, we could see each value available on the list of employees, and we could be able to get the index of that each employee object. In the sense, each employee comma index, it goes to, in the sense we are going to get each employee object. If you want you can mark it as a employee again because it's an employee type only at the end. And as we discussed in the mapper, the second one is number, that is nothing but index of this. Okay, in the sense, the mapper contains two callback functional parameters. One is each object present in this employee. The second one is like index of that employee's object. Now let me go and add it all these values to logger e dot. Then we could see all the list of properties are available in this. The first one is like employee ID, the second one is like employee name, the third property get employee, which is an optional property, and is in it IT or not, console.log, the salary. Now we are not going to check with this get employee. For example, if you are really working with any like TypeScript, any React or Angular framework, then we are going to see the get employee function actual implementation. But at this time we are not going to discuss about this. In the upcoming sessions we'll integrate this TypeScript with React, and we will discuss about all this functional, all about this function, advantage of optional parameter, marking this function as optional, and marking these properties with optional and all. Okay, now let me go and see whether we're going to see all these property values in logger or not. Okay, as we discussed, this employee ID will be undefined. If we are not defining any property from this, then the default value for this is like undefined. Let me go on, click on run. If you click this run right, then this piece of code will get run, and at the end the employees will be iterate on each object are available, and this will be a log into our console. Let me go and click on run. Then in the log we can see the first value is like undefined, in the sense the employee ID, in the first object of this employee ID property is not defined any value. That's the reason we are seeing undefined. Consequently, we can see all the values here. For example, if we need to check whether the employee ID is having a value or not, then just have like this. If e dot employee ID, then it will check whether the employee ID is not null and it contains some value. Then we log the employee ID. Else, we'll console the value is undefined. Let me go and run it again. Before running it, here we could see that we can clear the existing logs and click run. Here we can see the first one is like undefined, and consecutively, yeah, let me just comment it. Before that, let me clear the console and click run. Here we can see the first object contains employee ID undefined, and the employee name is Krishna, true, 1000, and the second consecutively, the employee ID is having two ID, ID is two. That's the reason we are not seeing any undefined. Okay, what I'm trying to say is like, if you are planning to check whether the property is having value or not, then we can simply use this syntax, like if e dot employee ID. In the next session, we'll see the advantage of any type in TypeScript. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to Mr. Dear Docs channel.